Welcome everyone to Juno's with Just a Commentary. Swaddy Crab, you guys requested that I react to this video. I got a video, this video request from my friend in Dominica. Well, not really a request, but he sent me this video. I didn't watch the video because I also got the request. I got three requests on Facebook. So I'm going to check out this video. I actually got this video from Facebook. So I want to thank you guys for requesting. Like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. If you want me to react to the video, leave a comment below. I will try my most best to react to it. Thank you so very much. Let's go ahead. Okay, once upon a time.
There was a king with four wives.
King with four wives.
One day, the king got sick and was on his deathbed. Afraid of being in the afterlife alone, he asked his fourth wife, which he loved the most, and bought her diamonds and gold and elegant clothing. He asked her, "Would you die with me and go with me to the afterlife?"
Wow.
The fourth wife replied, "I'm sorry, I can't do that," and walked away. He also loved his third wife and was very proud and would always show her off to neighboring kingdoms. So he called on his third wife and asked, "Would you accompany me to the afterlife?" The third wife replied, "I love my life too much, and I'm sorry I cannot go with you. And when you die, I'm going to remarry."
She even tell that to
him.
The
second wife has always been there for him in his times of need. So he asked, "Would you accompany me to the afterlife?" The second wife then replied, "I'm sorry that I can't help you out this time. But what I can do is arrange your funeral, and I will be there for your funeral." A voice called out and said, "I'll leave with you and follow you wherever you go, even if it is to the afterlife." And the king looked, and it was his first wife. But this was the wife that he took care of the least. Felt embarrassed and said, "I'm sorry, I should have taken more care of you and given you more attention when I was alive." The moral of this story is that we all have four wives. Our fourth wife is our body. We like to decorate it with nice jewelry, nice clothing. But in the end, it can't follow us to the afterlife.
That is true.
The third wife represents our possessions.
Wow.
We spend so much time trying to gather possessions, but in the end, they cannot follow us to the afterlife. It will be given to other people and divided, just like the third wife said she's going to remarry. The second wife, our friends and family. We trust them. They're always there for us in times of need. But the furthest they can go with us is to our funeral and send us off. Our first wife, the first wife represents our soul. We usually neglect taking care of our soul. That is the thing that will follow us to the afterlife. Care for your body. Keep it healthy. Enjoy your possessions and the comfort they provide. Cherish your friends and family for the love that they provide.
Yeah.
But don't forget to take care of your soul. Nourish your soul. Take time to be alone. Take time to pray. Take time to meditate.
Yeah.
Because it is the source of all of your life and your most faithful friend. I hope this story can help you or somebody that you love. My name is Sean. Udanakiran.
Sadiqap. Wow. I actually love this meaningful video. And that is very true. That is actually very true because I'm going to use myself as an example in Dominica. After Hurricane Maria, many of us in Dominica lost our comfort. We lost television, we lost the internet, most persons lost their homes, they lost their vehicles, these sort of things. Some persons fell sick, they had stress, these sort of things, their body fell sick. Some persons lost their family members. Some family members left the country and went away. So, and at the end of the day, those who are strong now, or those who make it, or the fact that we made it through, is because of our mental strength. Because for a moment we didn't have any water and food coming in. For a moment we lost all our possessions. For a moment all the comfort was gone. For the moment even calling our families and friends was not a possibility after Hurricane Maria. because this was a category 5. They say no greater hurricane than category 5. But I think to me it was a category 20, but this don't exist. But the fact of the matter is we lost it. We lost our strength physically, not able to eat, persons felt sick, stressed out. So when you see everything you've had, everything you work for is gone. Some persons lost their family members, some left the country almost the day after. Some were not able to communicate with their loved ones, mother right this way, father right this way, and maybe in another village. No communication, nothing. Television, internet, everything gone within an hour. And what kept most persons strong, and up to this day, what is keeping us strong is the fact that taking care of your own soul, taking care of your being, because your body will still fall sick, your body will still be thirsty, but you have to be mentally strong. You have to take care of your mental strength, you know what I mean? Take care of that being. And for most persons, I am not quite sure, a lot of persons may not believe in God, some persons might not believe in Jesus Christ, but for a lot of persons, they believe in God Almighty, they believe in Jesus Christ, and that was a source of strength for their soul. The comforting spirit that God will see us through this. The comforting knowledge that God is in control of it all, and that when things look dark, God have some plan in mind. And that is all connected to some way or another, our soul. This is connected to our inner being, our spirit. And I think this is very important. I love this message and I love the story that it brought. And most of us need to focus on strengthening our mental being, our soul, our spirit. Meditate, pray, whatever it is that you believe in. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ. I believe in God Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, sending his son Jesus Christ to die for us as sinners. That's who I believe in. Some persons believe in Buddha. Some persons believe in, like in India, they believe in the spirit of the cows and so on and so forth. Everybody have what they believe in. I'm not here to lambast anyone for what they believe in. Of course, everybody wish everybody would believe in what they believe in. But the fact of the matter is, we all have this inner spirit in us. It's, all of us have one thing in common. We've got a soul. We've got a spirit. We've got that moment when we're alone that we are thinking, we are remembering, we are feeling bad, we're feeling good. There's this mental thing beyond our skin, beyond our jewelry, beyond our possession. And I think that is something that we all share in common, right, guys? So I want to thank you guys for requesting this video. Of course, don't forget, like us on Facebook, follow us on Twitter. If you want me to react to the video, leave a comment below. I'm going to try my utmost best to react to it. Thank you so very much. Bye, guys.
Every man to himself, your life is yours and no one else's. At the end, you've either done it right or you've wasted it now. You use you, then turn around and desert you. Let them know your plans and they try to reverse you. The careless people ain't got no virtue. They be tripping and flipping and this and all that you do. Don't be tripping of them, cause they be jealous of you. They be wishing they could walk in your shoes.
Cinema.
It's what the world is made of. They can't reach your level, so they try to bring you down to where they are. But you are strong, so you hold on to the top where you know that you belong. What you want, you gotta do it yourself. Every man to himself. Your life is yours and no one else's. At the end, you've either done it right or you wasted your life.